अस्सलाम वालेकुम, माय नेम इज़ तुबा यूनुस एंड माय रोल नंबर इज़ BB1650241 एंड आई एम फ्रॉम ग्रुप एन. द मेन टॉपिक इज़ एसिड बेस्ड डिसऑर्डर्स एंड द टॉपिक ऑफ इंटरेस्ट इज मेटाबॉलिक एसिडोसिस विद हाई और एलिवेटेड आयनाइन गैप. सो बेसिकली एसिड बेस्ड डिसऑर्डर्स अकर व्हेन द आर्टेरियल ब्लड सैंपल pH इज इंक्रीज और डिक्रीज. इफ द pH इज ग्रेटर देन 7.4 देन पर्सन माइट बी सफर फ्रॉम मेटाबॉलिक अल्कलोसिस और रेस्पिरेटरी अल्कलोसिस. And if the pH of blood sample is less than 7.4, then there are chances of metabolic acidosis or respiratory acidosis. Before proceeding towards a case study, we must know about the condition, causes, and diagnostic criteria. So first of all, we will see that basically what happens in metabolic elevated NN gap. It is a form of metabolic acidosis, generally characterized by a high NN gap. The reasons of high NN gap is the body is producing too much acid, or ultimately the kidneys are not removing enough acid from the body. The second reason is that there are relatively low levels of cations. Obviously, when the level of cations in the blood serum is low, then the chances of concentration of NN in the blood serum is increased. Other than sodium and potassium, and there are several types of metabolic acidosis occur grouped by their influence on the NN gap. And NN gap is usually considered to be high if it is over 12 milli equivalent per liter. Now, what are the causes of metabolic acidosis with elevated NN gap? The first foremost cause is production of acid in cerebral body is increased. The second reason is ketoacidosis, lactoacidosis, kidney failure, toxins, and the more rarely, it may be caused by ingesting methanol or overdosing of aspirin. In ketoacidosis, excessive free fatty acid metabolism occur that result in the production of ketoacids, acetoacetic acid, and beta-hydroxybutyrate. And in lactoacidosis, it may result from excess formation and decreased metabolism of lactate. Now the formula that is delta ratio, this formula is used that can be assessed elevated NN gap metabolic acidosis and to evaluate whether mixed acid base disorder is present or not. The whole causes of metabolic acidosis are summarized in an acronym form that is CAT MUD PILES. This whole acronym consists of several reasons and drugs that may lead towards metabolic acidosis, including carbon monoxide, cyanides, theophylline, toluene, methanol, iron, isoniazid, ethylene glycol, salicylates, aspirin, paracetamol, pyrrolidine, and the conditions that may lead towards metabolic acidosis with elevated NN gap include diabetic ketoacidosis, alcoholic ketoacidosis, starvation ketoacidosis, and lactic acidosis. Now the sign and symptoms. If person suffering from metabolic acidosis with elevated NN gap, then person may feel nausea, vomiting, fatigue, cardiac dysfunction, with hypertension, shock, ventricular arrhythmias. And the basic treatment is to give alkalizing agent, that is sodium bicarbonate. IV sodium bicarbonate is indicated when acidosis is due to change in bicarbonate level. IV sodium bicarbonate is though controversial in high NN gap acidosis, but may be considered when pH is less than 7 with a target pH of 7.10 pH. Now the case study. If a person ages 34 years old, having a weight of 60 kg is brought to the emergency department by the police in a semi-comatose state. He was found lying on the floor of his hotel room 30 minutes ago. He has a long history of alcohol abuse, and in the emergency department, supine blood pressure, pulse rate, and respiratory rate is calculated or is noted. A patient has reactive pupils and mild papilledema is noted. Laboratory test reveals the following concentration of electrolytes in the patient's serum, and on the basis of these concentrations, in the basis of these levels, we will further assess that whether acid-base disturbance is present in the patient or not. And if acid-base disturbance is present, then what are the possible causes of the disorder? The chief complaint of patient is that the patient was found in semi-comatose condition, having dilated pupil and papilledema. Edema. Subjective includes the patient initials at gender male. His age is 34 and having weight of 60 kg, and patient is having a long history of alcoholic abuse. Objective, in objective, we will see the electrolyte ranges of serum. The serum concentration of sodium is 140 milliequivalent per liter. The serum concentration of potassium is 5.8 milliequivalent per liter. Chlorine is 103 milliequivalent per liter. Blood urea nitrogen is 25 milligram per deciliter. Creatinine is 1.4 milligram per deciliter. Fasting glucose is 150 milligram per deciliter. Arterial blood gas pH is 7.16, and the partial pressure of carbon dioxide is 23 milligram of mercury, and the bicarbonate ions concentration in patient serum is 8 milliequivalent per liter. Now come towards assessment. Considering the serum electrolyte concentrations, clinical diagnosis suggests that person is might be suffering from metabolic acidosis. Why we will suggesting the person having metabolic acidosis? Because we will pick 2 to 3 factors from the patient lab results. First is the level of bicarbonate in serum is 8 milliequivalent per liter, and this level in the patient serum is quite low. Also, the arterial blood gas pH is 7.16, and these two parameters are showing that person is suffering from acidosis. Now we will have to calculate the NN gap to evaluate or to suggest that person whether person is suffering from metabolic acidosis with elevated NN gap or not. For this, we have to calculate the NN gap, and for calculating NN gap, we will pick 2 to 3 levels from patient lab result, that is sodium level, chloride level, and bicarbonate level. So the sodium level is 140, chloride level is 103, and bicarbonate level is 8. By subtraction and addition, we will get 29 milliequivalent per liter NN gap. So the normal NN gap is 3 to 10 milliequivalent per liter, and this ranges vary from literature to literature by having 3 factors, that is bicarbonate, ABG level, and NN gap. We will have a clue that person have metabolic acidosis with elevated NN gap. Also, the serum osmolality is 332 milliosm per kg, showing increased level. The osmolal gap is 35 milliosm per kg, and person is not suffering from diabetes and chronic renal failure. Why we are saying that person is not suffering from diabetes and chronic renal failure? Because there is no history of patient to have diabetes and chronic renal failure in the past or in the present. So we would simply suggest about methanol induced metabolic acidosis with elevated NN gap. Also, person is having a long history of alcoholic abuse. So this assessment is justified that person is suffering from methanol induced or drug induced metabolic acidosis with elevated NN gap. Now, what is methanol induced metabolic acidosis with elevated NN gap? Methanol intoxication results in the formation of 2 organic acids. The first is formic acid and second is lactic acid, which consume bicarbonate with production of an metabolic acidosis. Alcohol dehydrogenase in the liver metabolize methanol to form formaldehyde and then to formic acid. The formic acid contributes to the metabolic acidosis and also is responsible for the retinal edema and blindness associated with methanol intoxication. So the main factor is formic acid, and we have to add such type of drugs in the patient regimen that block formic acid formation. The diagnostic test result that will prefer are NN gap and osmolal gap, because these two tests will further provide us the authentication that person is suffering from this disease or not. Now the plan. The supportive management for methanol intoxication includes airways protection, circulatory support, correction of metabolic abnormalities, and control of seizures. Bicarbonate therapy is the second option for supportive management. Bicarbonate-based intravenous fluids should be given to all patients with acidosis due to methanol intoxication. So this is mandatory therapy. Now the drug treatment, fomepizole, can be given intravenously as a 15 milligram per kg loading dose over 30 minutes, followed by bolus doses of 10 milligram per kg Q12 hourly. Because of induction of metabolism of fomepizole, doses should be increased to 15 milligram per kg every 12 hours if therapy is required beyond 2 days. Fomepizole is usually continued until the serum methanol concentration is less than 20 milligram per deciliter, 6.2 millimole per liter. The second drug of choice in methanol intoxication is ethanol. The standard loading dose of ethanol is 0.6 gram per kg, followed by a constant infusion to keep the blood ethanol level between 100 and 200 milligram per deciliter. The average maintenance dose of ethanol is 100 milligram per kg per hour, but is significantly higher for alcoholics and must also be increased while the patient is on dialysis. Blood ethanol levels should be checked every 1 to 2 hours until a steady state has been reached, and then every 2 to 4 hours. So these are the two drug of choices. The first is fomepizole and second is ethanol. Now the adverse effects related to these drugs. Ethanol has a potential adverse effects of central nervous system depression, hyperglycemia, respiratory depression, and aspiration. Fomepizole adverse effects are relatively mild, consisting of headache, nausea, dizziness, agitation, metallic taste, abnormal smell, and rash. Fomepizole is more potent drug that block alcohol dehydrogenase enzyme. Why these two drugs are preferred? Because these two drug mechanism of action is to block the alcohol dehydrogenase enzyme. And when alcohol dehydrogenase enzyme is blocked, the further formation of formic acid is stopped. Inhibition of alcohol dehydrogenase, why it is important, ethanol and fomepizole. The main objective of treatment of methanol intoxication is to limit the accumulation of formate. This is achieved by inhibition of alcohol dehydrogenase with either ethanol or fomepizole. Both have been to shown to slow the metabolism of methanol to formate. So we have to stop the conversion of methanol into formate, because formate is the real cause of disease progression. One of these two antidotes should be used as soon as possible to prevent the production of formate. Indications for the use of either ethanol or fomepizole include a serum level greater than 20 milligram per deciliter, a high osmolal gap after ingestion of methanol, and a high index of suspicion for methanol intoxication in a critically ill patient. The dose of both inhibitors of alcohol dehydrogenase has to be increased during dialysis. Fomepizole may be preferred antidote in methanol intoxication because levels do not need to be followed. It has fewer side effects, does not cause further sedation, and it has a much simpler dose scheme. Thank you.